You see, life is like an apple. I'm just fucking with you. I'm gonna fucking eat this one. Ugh. Is there tides on lakes? I feel like there is. I feel like it is coming up. I don't know though. I was gonna do some hop antsy if you wanted to kick it. This works so much better when there's things to grab onto. Ah, there it is. I don't know if you can see the gravel that comes in and then washes back with the undertow. That looks like LSD. It looks like when everything grows and then dies. I always kind of get tired of apples, but like 2/3 of the way in there, I'm usually just powering through it till it's done. Another offering. The water's definitely getting closer. It is accelerating quickly. Maybe that was like the 49th wave. I'm surprised they don't have people like wind sailing or whatever. Windsurfing? I mean, I guess it's not that windy. Thank you. Looks like I specked the monkey. Thank you for sharing that with me. I saw my own face. I was like staring at my own face. And I had like shadow around the edges. It was like flickering in and out sort of. And then I just let the whole shadow take my face. And that's when I said hello to myself. And I said that I loved you. And then that's when it started twirling. It like moved away. So I could see my whole like body. And it was all shadow and it was just twirling. And kind of like dancing, sort of. And that's when I was like going woohoo for it. And then I let it go and play. And I came back to my center, just like white light, sort of. And then my hands were getting cold, I was noticing, and I just relaxed into the discomfort as best I could. And just stayed with that center. And then I made an offering to the sea, to Poseidon. Little hobo camp. Yeah, so I always like rehearse my videos sort of before I actually turn the camera on, and I always have like profound insights in my head, and I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna share that, and it's gonna be legendary. And then when I flick the camera on, I'm always like, duh, what? And it never comes out like it goes in my head, which I feel like that's like the daydreaming aspect of life, you know, like all of us have these ideal, maybe not all, but I have these like fantasies that are like sweet as fuck. And I get lost in them sometimes, especially at night. It's like where a majority of my insomnia comes from. And it's fun to like entertain those things, but in the end, that's where like expectations and disappointment can arise from. It's like, shit. That's why travel is like so weird. Because wherever you are, there you are. Wherever you go, there you are. You know, it's like trying to obtain those fantasies is what Alan Watts say. Like, desire is the root of all suffering. I don't know if he said that, but like, how do you manifest those desires to actually happen? That's another thing of like the holding on. Like, these fantasies I have, I like don't necessarily care if they come true. So I do release them, but in the end, it's like I still block myself from having similar experiences, you know? Because they could easily come true. I'm not fantasizing about like stuff out of my reach. It's all within grasp. But getting back to like just attracting what you're meant to experience, you know? That's, and then being okay with that experience. That's how you do it. Like, I had expectations about this beach, you know? But the beauty is, like, the experience that you do have is always different. That's sort of, like, the beauty in it. Sort of like when you go to sleep and dream. Those are always like what? And then when you wake up, you're like, cool. You're not like trying to have the same dream every time. But yeah. Thanks for sharing.